Hi! You've made it to the Connextras video where I explain what the heck is going on with these wires and all the stuff that I did with this dehumidifier here. If you got here without seeing the main channel video, there's a clicky thing. This is to explain an experiment that I ran on this thing and why it didn't work. Well, I actually don't know why it didn't work, but my idea did not pan out. So, to give you a quick recap of what that video was about, that way you don't have to watch the whole thing if you don't want to. This is a rotary desiccant dehumidifier, and the Cliff Notes version of how it works is this wheel of silica gel rotates very slowly. Air is drawn through the whole wheel except for this bay section here. The bay section has a heating element which is getting the wheel very hot, so it releases the moisture, and then that hot, damp air goes through this heat exchanger where it condenses into liquid and goes into a bucket. It's a clever idea, but it's not very energy efficient. And I had this question in my head, which was, is this actually an optimal amount of time for the silica gel to be charging versus regenerating? The wheel rotates at about 1/2 of an RPM. It takes almost exactly 2 minutes for it to rotate, which means it's exposed to the room air for about 80 seconds, and then it's recharged for about 40 seconds. And I was just not entirely convinced that that was optimal. I had no idea how much, you know, moisture the silica gel could reasonably be expected to absorb in 80 seconds, but I just wasn't convinced that that was enough time. So I got my, you may remember these temperature controllers from the space heater, well, not the space heater video, the HVAC system sizing video. And these happen to have a duty cycle control mode. So I set one of these up to run for 4 minutes on and then 4 minutes off. And I disconnected the wires from the heating element and the blower motor that actually pushes air through here, and I'll explain my reasoning there. And I wired them to a plug and plugged it into this. So first, I just did a preliminary test where I had it exactly as you see it now, completely out of its case, but powered on and operating. It didn't seem to care that I had disconnected the heater and the blower motor. It was working fine. And so this 12-volt fan was running, pulling air this way, but it was completely out of its case. And that meant the airflow situation was not normal, and there would be very little airflow to cool off the straw radiator thing. So I literally just put a paint can here with a tiny little desk fan blowing at this, and let it run for 2 hours as normal. In that time, it extracted 60 grams of water, which was nowhere near what it can normally do, but that made sense because, again, it's completely sitting out like this. So of course it's going to be a different number. So then I unplugged the heating element thing from the wall and plugged it into my duty cycle controller, which turned it on for 4 minutes and then turned it off for 4 minutes. And my thinking was, that's going to make sure the desiccant wheel actually gets 4 minutes of exposure to the air before it starts regenerating, and then it will have 4 minutes of operation as this thing typically operates. And I killed the blower motor on purpose, thinking that I would want to completely shut, like I would want to stop the flow of hot air as quickly as possible. And if this was continuing to go on, then the moisture that was in these tubes would potentially just get reabsorbed onto the desiccant as it was moving through. So it felt like it made sense to turn off both the heating element and the little blower here. And surprise, surprise, despite the fact that I had cut the power draw in half by turning the heating element, by running it at a 50% duty cycle, it extracted 70 grams of water. So it got more water out of the air with half power. And my mind at first was like, Eureka! This thing is put together poorly. Why didn't they design it differently? But because my brain understands the fundamentals of science, I changed way more than just one variable. So before I concluded that that actually meant anything, I needed to somehow get this back in its case and do the experiment again. And that I actually filmed. The first one, I just took pictures of the water readings, I think. And I actually filmed the setup of the second test. And then, well, it didn't work. First, the thing broke. It just wasn't, it was suddenly beeping nonstop. And what that very well might have been, it has two temperature sensors in the heater circuit thing to determine if it's overheating. And I thought they might be thermal switches, which opened. They don't seem to be based on my testing with a voltmeter. So I don't know if that's why it died. But certainly what I was doing by killing the power to the heating element and the blower at the same time, things were getting hotter than they should be. When operating as normal, whenever you turn this off, it keeps the fans running for like 30 seconds and then turns off. So I knew I was kind of asking for trouble. But regardless, nothing actually broke. It's just the control circuitry was deciding, I'm not going to work for you anymore. So I then had to wire the fan to these wires here. That way I could run this in completely manual operation. So I needed to, this wire was going to a second plug. This was going to a DC power supply to run the fan. And then the plug that I had already wired to here, the heating element in the blower, went into this thing. Well, and the wall originally. So I repeated the tests with it fully powered on as normal, just the control circuitry was not awake for any of this. And I think, hold on, I wrote this down somewhere. So once it was reassembled with the wires poking out carefully and having everything running as it should, it extracted 159 grams of water in 2 hours, which is pretty typical. And then I plugged the heating element and blower into this, and it extracted 74 grams of water. So it's, yeah. I was pretty bummed when that happened because I really thought that I had stumbled upon, like, there's something, because this thing just runs the heating element at full power in the high fan speed mode. That's what I meant. It runs in full, the heating element is just on if you have this in its maximum power mode. And that just didn't seem right. It seemed like that might not be right, but it's right. So the experiment was a failure. 80 seconds appears to be just as much time as required for this to absorb as much moisture as it can hold on to. And, you know, in hindsight, that kind of makes sense. I mean, it's not like this can actually hold on to much moisture at all. You never see it wet. That's not how this works. It's just, I mean, on the molecular level, I couldn't tell you what's happening, but molecules of water are sticking to the silica gel, and then they're being able to push out from the other thing. But the 80 seconds in the airstream and then 40 seconds in the hot airstream appears to be pretty close to ideal. So I have no idea what happened when I tested it the first time, why it was able to get more moisture, but I'm guessing that was just a fluke because it was only a small... Well, the other thing it could be is when this is running at half power, it does cut the power to the heating element in half. I shouldn't say half power. In the night mode, I think is what it calls it. The power draw drops to about 150 watts. So when it slows down the airflow, it also slows down the heating, or it lowers the heating power. So I guess effectively, because the airflow was messed up in my situation, I was doing the same thing with the heating element, cutting it down to half power, but I was doing it through a duty cycle, through timing, rather than actually lowering the power level, if that makes sense. Yeah, so this is just kind of a bit of a rambly quick explanation of what I was doing. I had started to write. I had a section in the script where I explained this experiment, but then I realized it doesn't do anything. It was just an excuse to make fun of the people who put this together, but they did nothing wrong. So, yep. That's all there is to this video. Bye!